Android 12 is almost here for Google Pixel phones, so it's about time Samsung and other OEMs kickstart their Android 12 public beta programs. Samsung has recently released their first beta of OneUI 4.0, which is based on Android 12, and I have it here on my Galaxy S21. First glance, it looks very similar to OneUI 3.1, but there are actually a ton of changes. I mean, look at this scrolling screenshot that I took of the full changelog. I'm definitely not going to go over everything on this list, plus there's going to be more stuff as Samsung releases more beta builds, but I'll show you some of my favorite changes and some notable ones that'll be useful for a lot of people. Now, before we get started, let's talk about our sponsor for this video, Western Rise. Western Rise is a men's clothing brand made for ultimate simplicity and versatility without giving up on style and sustainability. Owning less and doing more with less is definitely something that speaks to me and my fashion choices as a guy. The Evolution Pants by Western Rise is a great example of this. Made with premium construction and sustainable manufacturing, it's perfectly designed for everyday wear, but it's so lightweight and stretchy that it can replace most of your other casual and outdoor pants. If you're a guy like me that has trouble finding the right fit, Western Rise is a brand that can be your one-stop shop. If you're interested in something like that, go tour their website using the link in the description and check out their entire lineup. So the very first thing that I noticed with this beta build is how much smoother and faster OneUI 4.0 is compared to 3.1. Don't get me wrong, the Galaxy S21 was always a fast phone, but the general speed and animations have never felt this great. Of course, being a beta build, there are a ton of crashes and bugs right now, but it's very nice to see that a performance upgrade like this is coming with just a software update. On the other hand, something that might be a little disappointing about this update is that Samsung's version of Android 12 doesn't adopt much of the Material U design language. From a glance, it really does look the same as it always did. But if you look a little closer, you'll notice a lot of little things have changed. So first off, let's go over the lock screen. The main change here is the new audio controls. No extra taps here. Depending on what audio app you're using, the lock screen player will display the custom controls specific to that app. Plus, you can now quickly and conveniently change the audio output to your connected headphones or speakers. When you plug in the charger, there are these colorful new visual effects, and it also shows the charging speed, which is useful. The always-on display now has an option to only turn on when you receive a notification. I actually don't like having the always-on display always on, so that's a pretty neat option for me. On the home screen, many of Samsung's home screen widgets have been redesigned with extra customization options and to display more info at a glance. For example, the clock app's dual clock widget now allows for different background colors for each city depending on whether it's day or night. I'm traveling to South Korea soon, so I'm glad Samsung made that change just in time. And using machine learning, OneUI will also recommend widgets that it thinks is useful for you. Then we've got dark mode, which of course was already there, but it's now darker. To make dark mode more consistent throughout the OS, OneUI will now automatically darken wallpapers and icons. Like a lot of other things in this update, it's a very subtle change that most people won't really notice. Something that's a little more noticeable is the notifications, which have become much smaller so you can see more notifications in a single view. So yeah, that's when you swipe down from the top, but there's also a few new things for when you swipe up from the bottom to do some multitasking. When you open a pop-up window, you can now set the menu to the top of the window so you can easily change modes with less taps. Then for picture-in-picture mode with something like a YouTube video, you can now pinch the zoom to resize the window. While we're on that topic, let's talk about Samsung DeX. More apps are now even more compatible. Apps that weren't able to be resized before can now do so. I know most people don't use DeX much, but I personally really like the feature, so it's nice to see any new changes coming to it. Okay, let's now move on to the more system stuff in the settings. The settings menu has pretty much stayed the same, but there are a lot of new things inside of each of these submenus. Safety and emergency is a new entry and sits as a one-way shop to edit and access your emergency info, such as medical information and emergency contacts. Then in battery and device care, it's got a refresh, more friendly look to it, tells you everything you need to know about the health of your phone in a singular view. Battery and security statuses are at the forefront, and if you do have issues, you just easily tap this button and boom, you're done. This new emoji will tell you if you're good to go. Then under advanced features, we have Bixby routines. I know none of you use Bixby, but Bixby routines is a pretty useful feature and it's got a few new updates. There are much more if and then conditions available, so you can now customize your routines to be even more than before. This means you can have your phone automatically do certain things like increase processing speed or connect to a Bluetooth speaker if a condition you set triggers. The biggest addition to the accessibility section is a new floating assistant menu button. It lets you access a bunch of accessibility features wherever you are in the OS. Privacy is one of the main focuses in Android 12, so there's definitely a lot of new changes here. This new privacy dashboard shows permission usage history, so you can easily see which permission is being used the most and which apps are accessing them. Here, you might find some apps accessing permissions that you didn't know about, so you can simply deny them right here. After you update to OneUI 4.0, whenever you open an app that you haven't opened yet since the update, it'll ask you if it can send you a notification or or not. On top of that, whenever an app is accessing your camera or microphone, OneUI will let you know with a visible green dot in the upper right corner. This way you can know if an app is recording you without your permission, and if so, you can go ahead and uninstall that app or disable that permission. Next, let's talk about the Samsung keyboard, which a lot of people do not like to use, but hey, I am okay with it and it's my default keyboard. So the top mini bar here has changed and there is now this emoji button that lets you access emojis, GIFs, and stickers super easily. And apparently text correction suggestions are a lot better now because the English keyboard is now powered by Grammarly. Okay, on to the camera app, which has a slightly new layout. The most noticeable change is the zoom levels. Now, when you change your zoom, you can simply tap the level that you want and not have to slide with your finger. The UI layout and settings for portrait, night, and pro modes have been a little bit reorganized. Professional mobile photographers will definitely like that. OneUI's camera app has already been able to scan for documents or QR codes, but now you can zoom in whenever you're editing the document. Then when you scan a QR code, you can choose what to do with the link. Then in the gallery app, you get extra photo and video editing options. You can now create video collages using multiple images and videos from your gallery. There's now a new light balance option to let you easily edit the tone of your photos. You can also cut out any object or person from a photo and paste it on another photo. Something not a lot of people will use but will appreciate is that you can now edit the date, time, and location of each photo and video. This might come in handy when someone sends you an edited old photo, but the time and location details are all wrong on the file itself. Now let's say you want to share a photo. As you all know, sharing on Android is kind of bad, so OneUI 4.0 and Android 12 are attempting to improve it a bit. You can now customize the list of apps that show up in the share panel, so you can have the apps that actually matter to you show up first. So less scrolling and less complexity. Before you send it, OneUI will also let you know if it thinks the photo you're sharing has bad focus or framing, so you get editing suggestions before you share a photo. Okay, that's basically all the notable changes coming with OneUI 4.0 for the Galaxy S21. There are a few other little changes with AR emojis and some Samsung apps, but these are the ones that matter the most to me. There are going to be a couple more beta builds with more changes before the official release, but let me know what you guys think of these changes in the comments down below. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe if you want more videos like this, and I'll see you guys on the next one.